even though you may later recognize your person and your problem, yes, the fact that you had an institutional marriage, you had dreams of what your marriage was supposed to be.
That's right.
And what you're looking forward to in the future. And for someone else to literally take that away from you, however, that's true. I know.
I cried my tears.
I totally get it. And I've been separated for 11 years. I just now found a divorce. I found a legal separation.
What are you doing today? I'm surprised.
And then we thought that was going to be enough. But I was
No, I just got
So what's happening?
She's just starting.
And who's parent? Which one's parent? Hmm? Which one?
Is you guys here?
She's doing it.
You guys here?
Yeah.
Well, you guys here?
A little louder.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah.
I mean, you're sitting right there.
Okay. I think you know me now.
But I was just thinking that same thing, that Verizon commercial. Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now?
Yeah, you should. It's not like I'm doing it right there today.
Okay. Okay.
Anyway, I'm so grateful and happy to be able to show up tonight. And I'm grateful and happy for all of you online that have come on board to check us out, because I know there's a million things to do in this world today, right? Everywhere you turn, there's something to do, something to distract you and take your attention away from your life. But you know, one of the things that I like to remind myself and you is that the most important thing that you can do in any given moment is put your time, attention, and money into yourself. Because once you do that, it's kind of like a domino effect. You know, you take care of you, you make yourself number one, and then you grow the chest and the shoulders. I'm about the chest. You can grow the shoulders that you can handle and take on so much more in your life. I often say to people that are very successful people that I know, I often say, it's amazing what you accomplish working against yourself. Can you imagine what you do when you get in harmony? Because we all have a destiny and a purpose, but we're fighting so many external things so much in so many ways. When the reality is, if we put our time and attention into ourselves, it's amazing you can figure everything else out. It falls into place. You know, I don't know anybody that has had that perfect life. I saw a commercial once that said at the convention of people from healthy families, and there's two people there. You know, we've all got stuff. But if we can just turn everything around and learn to put our attention into ourselves and be the best that we can be and giving ourselves the best that we can, it's amazing how everything starts to fall into place. I've certainly witnessed that my entire life. 77 years I've been on this planet. It's good.
People online
feel happy. Uh-oh. They can't see me? They can't see me?
They can't hear you.
Why that? Mic's
they on. Can't hear you online.
Oh. Well, it's supposed to be this, though. Oh, you know what? I don't know if the YouTube. That's a Dana thing. I'm sorry.
I'm going to grab Dana.
Oh,
no, she can grab one. I'm so sorry. Okay. I don't know, because this isn't my generation. Who can't hear me, the YouTube or the Instagram? Who can't hear me, the Instagram?
Yeah, my cousin just called, and a customer just called. She said Instagram or YouTube.
YouTube. Well, go run over to Instagram, because I know that's mic'd up. I don't know what's going on with YouTube, folks. Go over to Instagram. I'm so sorry.
Oh, here she goes.
They can't hear me on YouTube. Can you hear me
on YouTube, they can't?
No. Do you just need to turn up his volume on this?
Maybe. Is
that?
Huh?
Hello?
Hello?
Can you
hear
me? It's on the side up to the top.
She heard you say go on this.
So they can hear you.
What's about
you? You heard that.
Okay.
And we're losing
sorry.
On YouTube. Okay. Is that cool?
Karen Calisleys. I'll send you the
nice
little
right
now. I wonder if this is true. I think this is true. One of these days we're going to get this right. Hi, everybody.
You go.
Is it going up?
Can you hear me now?
I can't see it.
Oh,
okay. It's all the way up.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, but I was. Oh. Okay. Yeah, I see. I see. Okay.
You can hear me now? Okay, sorry about that. One of these weeks, these months, we're going to get this right, I promise. If I have to stay up and study all night myself, right? Because I'm always whining and complaining about people making change, and I need to make this change in mind. I keep thinking I have people around me. Anyway, well, thank you for showing up, and once again, making yourselves important, because there's so many things you can be doing and saying. And for me, and I see some of you again, like Gina's here again, and Susan, is hearing the message over and over and over again. If they don't put one commercial on TV and expect you to get it, you get that commercial day in and day out, and everywhere you turn, there's something coming at you, telling you how to be in fear of life, how to take some kind of chemical, how to stay away from nature and life. I mean, everything is about that. It's about separating us from the reality of how we're supposed to live. It's about separating us and indoctrinating us so that we believe that this is just going to happen. You know, the axis of the world went around one more time. I'm a year older and I'm getting old. And you start to believe it, and you start to fall in place with it. Oh yeah, I'm older, I'm getting fatter, I'm older, I'm getting tired. There's no reason to be tired and old just because the axis went around one more time. It means you're supposed to run more, work a little bit hard, because things do start to deteriorate a bit. Just gravity of the earth, just the air, the oxygen levels that we live with, just the whole generalization of what the world has become. We're not living in a hostile place for human beings.
Yes.
The air quality, the food quality, the way we treat each other, the whole thing. So I'm saying every opportunity that we can to make a difference in our own lives, gratitude. One thing I do every single morning when I wake up in the morning, I'm in gratitude. I woke up, you know, a million people didn't. I woke up, my friends are still up, you know, and you can be grateful no matter what's going on. You feel well, and you have another chance to make your dreams come true, or get something right, or do something different, or add to the world. You know, you have another chance. But meanwhile, people walk around whining and complaining all day long. I'm tired. I need to be afraid. I'm this, I'm that, I've got headaches. And you're a waste of time, really. Because what you speak is what you believe you become, too. You're giving oxygen to it. That's why when people come around and they start to complain, I change the subject. I don't want to hear, I don't want to give oxygen to whatever you feel is real in your life. It's not that I don't feel for your heart because you haven't figured it out, but I'm not going to let you use me to take you down that rabbit hole. You know, tell me what's positive, loving, and wonderful, and you can find something. You can always find something. So, with that being said, and you showing up tonight, it's a great opportunity to learn better how to take care of your bodies and yourself. And I don't believe I have all the answers. I'm not a doctor. I'm not a scientist. I don't even like science that much. You know, when people ask me, well, how is this working? I'm like, I can't tell you the science behind it. Thank God you have Google, you have the internet. So whatever I say, you can look it up now and decide for yourself. Because everything isn't for everybody at every moment of their lives. Just because you hear something doesn't mean all of a sudden you're going to sit down and start doing it. Sometimes things have to get in there and percolate and marinate, and the life has to come around, and you have to fall down some more ditches. You know, before everybody says, enough, I'm ready to do something. But that's what I'm here for, to continually offer you opportunities to do something different. And I don't think my way is the only way. I think there are many roads to the top of the mountain, and we're given those choices. And I think it's up to us to listen, pay attention, and then meditate, pray, whatever it is, and see what feels right for you this moment. If somebody had told me I was going to be living this way 50 years ago, I would have said you were crazy. You know, I used to make fun of people that didn't eat germ. So to tell me I'd be plant-based and raw for all these years and living my life, I would have said, what are you talking about? And I come from a very typical American black family, you know. Typical to the extent, though, is that they all die overweight and young. You know, they started out skinny like me. By the time my mother was in her 30s, she was overweight and dead at 47. My grandmother, overweight and dead at 50. My great-grandmother, overweight and dead at 60. Now, I'm going to make a clarification there, because overweight then is a lot different than overweight is today.
Yes.
It's a whole different ballgame. And it's actually frightening to see what people are accepting within themselves that it's considered normal. We weren't born to grow up like that, it's like not. It's directly related to the chemicals, to what we're putting, the lack of, and the intention of what we're putting in our systems in the wrong way. There's no other reason. But yet the media and marketing is making you accept it as normal. This is just the way it is. Be comfortable with it. You know, you go on Target and the mannequins are plus size now.
Are they?
Oh yeah, they're plus size. And God bless people, I'm not body shaming, God bless people. It's just not healthy. How many 85-year-old overweight people do you meet?
Not a lot.
Not, because they're not here.
Right, they don't live.
They don't live.
So I'm just saying, we have to step outside of the matrix of what we're being taught is normal, or being marketed into being normal, and make some inroads into ourselves and learn to do something different. That's what I'm all about. Like I said, I don't believe it's my way or the highway. I think there's many roads to the top of the mountain. But I also believe I've done and lived this for the past 50 years, and I think I got some answers for you. You know, I'm on the planet 77 years. I'm opening up businesses. I'm never sick. I'm never tired. I got the same body I had at 18. You know, so I think I got a few answers. I'm not just talking about something I read from a book or heard one person say. I've lived it, and I've gone to the pitfalls. I've gone to the depths that I've come up. I've gone to the depths that I've come up. It's part of the process of life. I don't believe we're here to be perfect. We're here for the evolution of our soul. So whatever lessons we're given to learn, we don't become a victim, we're learning and we keep moving forward. And that's what this is all about. Because jumping into any type of new food program, you've got tapes that have been playing there for a lifetime. And they're not just going to turn around and stay where they are. We have to massage them a little bit. You know, I ran into a guy this morning and I was walking my dog. And he said, oh, I'm getting ready to do a 3-day cleanse. You know? And I said, oh, are you wrong? No, I'm just going to juice for 3 days. Well, for me, that's not a very healthy thing to do, eating steak one day and juice the next day. You know, the body doesn't understand it's what you're calling a fast. It thinks it's starving to death. And so the minute you come off that 3 days, you're going to want more sugar, more this, more that, more cravings, and you're going to blow up. But you can talk and brag your friends that you did a 3-day cleanse. I don't know that it's serving people. Maybe it's serving somewhere where you had a chance to see what it felt like to give up. And a lot of times when you go back and you go back twice as much, it doesn't really encourage you to keep on the path. And that's what I'm all about, is giving you all the pitfalls that I did along the way, making new changes, how things work with them. You can't hear me on there now?
No, not on Instagram.
How could that be?
I don't know.
Is this true, though? Oh, this isn't on. All that great stuff I said in the store, this wasn't on. Can you hear me now? Let's go back here.
It was on at one point.
But this wasn't on. Maybe it'll be on the video, guys, and you can go back and see it later. No, it was already in. Yeah, I told you it was. Yeah, 4, 2, 2.
I got it.
I just gave my whole thing. I just gave my passcode on the bottom. See, it's the one already written. I'm still putting it in. See, there's one on there.
Okay, gotcha.
There we go.
The great thing about that, Karen, you can change it.
Okay. There, can you hear me now? Because we have a nice bunch of people. Can you hear me now, people?
Thanks.
I said so many great things, so you can go to the YouTube or you can go to YouTube. We're going to get this right one of these times. I'm sorry for the people here. One of these days we're going to get it right. You know, so many people signed up to do it online, now they're all gone. I'm sorry. Well, you're here, so we'll just continue. So like I was saying, it's the ins and outs, the ups and downs, but it's knowing that there is no ceiling and that you have to continue to learn and grow and change. So, with that being said, how many people here in the room or online are already on a plant-based diet?
Raise your hands.
100%, right?
Not 90, no. I would say maybe 80.
80%, okay. Well, I'm here to make a recommendation that you look into going all the way for 9 short days. So if you're consistently doing, this is how you change habits and this is how you see a change. And so often what happens is people make a change and they don't see all the results they expect right away within the first 2 or 3 days, and well, I'll just have a little of this and then go back and I'll have a little of this. So one of the things that I've done and created is what I call a 9-day revival. So you can make a commitment and make 9 consecutive days of being plant-based. So why do you want to do that?
Oh, this is sucking.
This is really, I'm feeling so bad, people. Mm.
Maybe that will work.
Well, this was off. I turned it on, so it should be working now.
She said she couldn't hear.
You still couldn't hear?
I hear you on YouTube.
Hello?
You hear me on YouTube?
Yes, ma'am.
Now I hear you. I hear you on Instagram now.
Okay, so this was off. I turned it on.
So
she
said she couldn't hear.
I just go to YouTube and
I'll
keep it up. I'll show you how to push on this.
Oh, you don't what?
You can't see it.
Oh, okay.
We're going to give this right one of these days, folks, I promise. Okay, this is embarrassing. I'm putting the echo right here. Thank you.
Oh.
Okay. This is very embarrassing. We will get it right one of these days, I promise. That's my goal, to get it right. And it's just like changing your diet and life too. You have to keep trying. You don't go from A to Z overnight. And this is our third class, and it's the same different mistakes. Mistakes again, third class. But by the fourth or fifth, we're going to have it down perfectly. I promise you, well, it's perfect if you can give it a human being. All right, so why would you want to do my 9-day revival? Because one of the most negative things that we do to the human existence on a consistent basis is putting the wrong material in. We're only supposed to eat for one reason. We're supposed to eat not because it's the time of the day, or not because somebody invited you out to dinner, or it's lunchtime and it's the only time you can eat something. We're supposed to eat to give the cells fuel. We're supposed to eat to feed ourselves so that we can continue to move throughout the day, so we can live in life. But unfortunately, we eat for every wrong reason, consistently. So think about this magnificent machine. I'm going to call it a machine. That you are consistently doing the wrong thing, giving it the wrong material, and it still allows you to get up and walk around. It still allows you to move throughout your day. But not at the optimum you could. You get to move throughout the day, you're tired, you're crabby, a million problems that come in your life. So I'm saying that by giving up meat, fish, sugar, and dairy, because that's what being vegan is, they call it plant-based, but I was vegan 50 years ago when I started.
You know, meat.
Fish, chicken, and dairy. Giving up all animal products. Giving up everything that has face, that has a life, that has a mother, that has a father, that has feelings. Because I'm here to tell you those animals that we enjoy are very loving animals. Cows and pigs are just as loving as dogs, more so than cats. They got a million things on there that we can go and see people in fact, and with cows and they're getting their like purring because they're getting the little heads well. Pigs can do agility like dogs can. They're that smart, you know. But yet they slaughter and kill and even a human thing twice about. And I'm saying that all of that destruction that you're creating is creating destruction within you too. Because it doesn't have to be. We don't have to kill and maim and torture to survive. In fact, we strive to survive 1,000 times better without doing that. I haven't had meat, fish, chicken, and dairy in 50 years. And I'm not falling apart, and I'm not lacking protein. I was taking a professional dance ballet class with girls 18 and under in my 70s. Okay. So it has nothing to do with what you've been marketing to believing is a reality to me. It is so detrimental to our systems on every level, vibrationally, feeding yourself, in every single way. It is detrimental to your system. Because every single thing you eat is what you become. Do you understand that? You eat a banana, that banana becomes a part of you. You eat a pig, that pig becomes a part of you. This is the building blocks of who you are. You start out as a baby like this. How do you grow to this size? Boom!
Everything you eat is what you become and what you grow into. So I say, let's think very carefully about what we're putting into our body. Do you want to be a cow? Do you want to be a pig? I know you have better names for it, pork chops and hamburger, and so you don't have to think about what you're doing. But the reality is, it was an animal, a living, breathing, caring, loving animal that was terrified and tortured to the end of its life. It's not like only down this farm anymore, they're outside in the sun and they get... No, when I see these trailers going by and the hole in them and the animals on there, and they know they're going to die. They know they're on the way. And you do it, because you don't have to think about what you're doing. I'm saying, if you're going to eat it, then do like the Indians, just pray for it, and then eat it. You know, give it some prayer. Maybe that's why we had grace at dinner time, too, when we put the vibration on it, and made it a little bit better for you. People aren't doing that anymore. They're driving through, and they're grabbing that ground up cow, and stuffing it in their mouths, and their paper bags, and throwing the paper bags out on the ground. It's just an incredibly negative system to be a creator. And all I want you to do is think. Just wake up and think about what you're doing. Think about it. You may not make the changes right away all at once, but think about what you're creating and what you're doing. Think about that brand new baby, grandchild, child of yours that you're shoving some dead cow or some dead pig. How about milk? How about milk? I'm told I need to talk louder.
Yes.
I'm just feeling so sad inside. You know, my voice kind of goes away and think about the animals. But so, I, in my 9-day revival, I recommend that you give up meat, fish, chicken, and dairy. And dairy being the worst of everything that we do as human beings to ourselves. Yeah, the cow doesn't have to die for it, but their babies are taken away so you get their milk instead of the babies. And then the babies are tenderized and become some other part of the animal that you eat. I don't know what it is. You know? But it's created for a baby calf. It's created for an animal that grows 6 to 800 pounds the first year of its life. What do you think it's doing to you every time you have some? You are growing as that baby calf is supposed to. And the animals in this country are given growth hormones to make sure they grow faster, steroids, antibiotics. And when you take in these foods, you're filling your system with these things. I know when I was breastfeeding my children, the doctor said, don't eat chocolate because it will give the baby diarrhea. Don't eat onions because it'll give baby gas. So where do you think those growth hormones, steroids, and antibiotics are going right into the lactating animal? And you're getting triple dosages of it. In our lifetime, 1 in 2 people will have cancer. When I was teaching 50 years ago, it was 1 in 10. It was 1 in 4. Now it's 1 in 2. It's every other person you know. Everybody here, there's no people close to you that are suffering from cancer at some point. And by the way, I will also add, when I was growing up in the 40s, 50s, and 60s, you didn't have all these cancer hospitals with children,
right?
The only people that had cancer was some old grandpa, grandma in the back room. Now it's everybody, younger and younger. It's breaking my heart. We just lost another young woman. She was in her 30s with small children. They're coming to me left and right. Where is it coming from? It's the lifestyle that they're living. So it's about making lifestyle changes. Yeah, I want you to do drastic ones, but drastic ones don't always work either. They may work for a while. I want you to find bridges that are comfortable across to get there. But going plant-based for 9 days, you won't recognize yourself. You won't recognize how you think. It really changes your thinking. I'm saying all of you are wired right where you can eat good animals and slaughter animals and it doesn't make you be born. But how about some of these kids and people that are just killing and maiming and so much a part of our world on a consistent basis. And where does it stop working and changing this within yourself? It's making these changes. So I offer this 9-day revival, I call it, because I'm so sick of the word detox and cleanse, to be honest with you. But really, I'm calling it a revival because I'm reviving in you what you already really know is right for you. We all intuitively know it's right. Everybody goes around with why too much of this, that, that, that's really. You know what's right. So I'm reviving in you, newborn. Every cell in your body came with a memory and a message knowing what it needed to replicate. But the fact is we put all the wrong stuff in consistently. We're breathing the bad air. I mean, we're getting the GMO, the genetically modified food, and we're wondering why the state of the world is like it is. through the hospitals and the sickness in our children, younger and younger. We can't go near a school with peanut in our hand anymore. When I was growing up, they had peanut butter sandwiches to school. Every neighborhood, they have these centers where, what do they call them? We roll the people in for their kidneys.
Dialysis.
I mean, it's like a scary movie, you know? They're rolling out ways to get people alive, and they're everywhere. And nobody's paying attention. It wasn't like that. I can see some people closer, not my oldest people, closer to my age. It wasn't like that when we were growing up. But you just accept it. And I'm saying, don't accept it. Wake up and do something different for yourself. Stop falling into, well, yeah, I was mad today. Well, what did that accomplish? You're feeding into the system, literally. Well, I didn't do so good there. Oh, but I get people, well, no, I'm sick now, so I can't able to do anything. Well, why are you sick? You're not sick because somebody sneezed on you. Everybody's so terrified of germs. I'm sick. Really? But what about all the chicken and ice cream and stuff you ate for the past 2 weeks? That's why you're sick, not because somebody in the same room sneezed on you. Once again, you don't have to have the responsibility for yourself. You can just run them off, run mayhem, and then wonder why nothing's changing with you, why you're still getting sick. I don't know what illness is at this stage of my life. I've had stuff along the way. I don't know what tiredness is at this stage of my life. I have 77 years on the planet, and I'm not special. I'm just devoting my life, selfishly so, to taking care of me. But because of that, I'm able to help thousands and thousands of people, and that's the way it works. You take care of you, and then you can help a lot of other people, your family, your friends. But nobody's going to listen to you. This is helping you to do this. You have to do it for you first. So when we do the 9-day revival, it comes with a little booklet, and you kind of make notes for yourself. You take measurements and stuff, because the things that happen so positively, subtly, you don't pay attention to. You just pay attention to what's negative. Don't you do that? You just pay attention to, I'm still tired, or I'm still, meanwhile, you woke up bright eyed, or you woke up, you weren't craving this. You're not paying attention to the positive things. I'm trying to give you a little booklet to be responsible for yourself. And I know a lot of the younger generation, you want to do it on your phone. That's okay too, but I still recommend you write it down. So that maybe 3-4 years from now, you can pick up the book and look at it again. And remind yourself where you were as opposed to where you're going to be. So it comes up with a little journal, and you get to write, believe it or not, you're moving, how you're thinking, and how you're treating people responds to what you're eating to. Everything, your menstrual cycle, all responds to what you're eating. You're not supposed to walk around sick and tired. But we have accepted it. And I'm here to say that you can make a difference. Do a little 9-day revival, and you go, oh my goodness, I can't believe how great I feel because you're paying attention to every little thing that's happening. You know, we have a rolling class going. We're going to start again. We got about 19 people doing the 9-day revival together. And I'm using this little, somebody told me it's outdated, the Marco Polo. So what the people in the class are doing it on the process is, you can pick up Marco Polo and you can say, oh, you know what, I didn't eat my coffee this morning, I didn't eat this, or Karen, you know what, I can't wait, I got to do this, I got to do that, and then I can respond to you like I'm with you. So I invite you, if you do decide to do the 9-day revival with us, that maybe you'll get on the Marco Polo and you'll have a community. This is a community. This is a community you can go down the negative pole, but it's a community that you move to up again. You know, I have to eat this because my mother made it, or my grandmother made it, or it's the family dinner. You know, we make people comfortable all the time while we kill ourselves. So, you know what? You will create a new community when we do this together. And this is for everybody. We have a lot of people online all over the country doing our little Marco Polo check-in and the 9-day revival. So you can go on the internet. We have a QR code here, and they'll put the QR code up here where you can click on it and you get a little bit more information about the class. And it's basically, I just kind of take over how you start your day. There are a few things to take with it, like I give you algae, which is the worst food on the planet for humans, so you're getting real food to the cells. I give you a green meal smoothie to drink, so you're getting all your nutrients, your protein, and calcium. And then you get to make the rest of your choices yourself, as long as it doesn't involve animals in some way. I give you ozonated magnesium to help you poop at night, so you're supposed to be able to walk around constantly and use them in real life. Lisa Dillon is pilot minds riding to putrefy, is feeding your organs. So we give you something to help you poop a little more at night, and then I give you digestive enzymes. We give you enzymes for every metabolic purpose in your body. When the enzymes are gone, that's when you die. And so every time you eat a meal, which is why some of us become raw foodists, and we're raw foodists, and that's part of the path you may decide to go on. Doesn't have to be the end result. But because you're getting enzymes as well with your food. So I give you digestive enzymes to take with your cooked or raw vegan plant-based food. And so your body metabolizes it differently. It doesn't sit in your system, it breaks it down. Even though I'm a raw foodist, I take enzymes in my food for those 77 years. My body isn't responding the way it did in my 20s. So I think one of the most important things that I recommend out of here are enzymes. And we have all kinds of health providers on board for you in the lecture and the question. So you have a little box there if you want to do the 9-day revival. And then after that, I do another class that's starting June 14th, which is my 28-day detox. And that's the one I'm kind of famous for. I was using the word detox for 50 years ago. There weren't a million people doing detoxes. They call everything a detox. I didn't eat chicken for one day, I'm detoxing, you know. But for me, that's not a full-blown detox. But I do have a 28-day detox coming up, June 14th. And I have a lot of clients and students who have been doing that with me for the past 34 years, a lot of repeat people. And to be honest with you, I do it. You see, part of my success, even though I'm plant-based for 15 years, even though I don't drink, smoke, or do drugs, I detox 4 times a year without fail. Because you see, I'm breathing the air out there. When man was created here, levels were at 38%. After the Industrial Revolution, they were down to 22%. We're now living in the teens in terms of oxygen in our environment. All cancer cells, all viruses, and they're what we call the virus, are anaerobic. They can't live in an oxygenated environment. So you're not getting it from the air. Unless you're raw like me, you're not getting it from your food. Which is why at the wellness spot next door, and maybe you have something in your city or country, we have hyperbaric chambers. And even though I'm eating raw and detoxing, I go in my hyperbaric chamber because I'm living in a hostile environment for human beings. I tell you, I live with stress with some restaurants and blah, 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 blah. I need to keep myself well oxygenated. So I have hyperbaric chambers next door. So, and by the way, we do recommend if you happen to be lucky enough to be in the city where we are, but they have these therapies all over now. When you're doing one of the detoxes or one of the revivals and what we're doing, it really can benefit you to do the therapies during, before, or after. We have colon therapy, hyperbaric chambers. We have something that we call foot therapy. You do 15 minutes in the infrared sauna, 15 minutes in the ozone, and a half an hour in the hyperbaric chamber. You look and feel like you've been on vacation for a week and you get out the next day. But all of these things are to help your body do what it knows how to do. It's to help your body regenerate. We are self-regenerating organisms. We get new cells every 7 years. We get new tissue every 3 months. The body is always regenerating. So if you cut your finger and do nothing to it, it doesn't heal all by itself. Bite your cheek and heals all by itself. We are a self-regenerating organism. Everything is designed to do that. But it doesn't get the chance to do it because we're so busy putting in the wrong stuff that it's got to try and break down and use some way, somehow. So it manifests in a million other ways and it doesn't spend the time to regenerate. Which is why I do my own detox 4 times a year. I just came up on for my birthday, April 20th. March 20th to April 20th, I do 30 days of perfection. Everything that I know to be perfect. So that when the birthday hits, I look and feel younger instead of being tired and old and pissed, right? That's one of my cleanses for the year, my birthday, you know. But I do 2 or 3 others, you know, and the older I get and when I have some extra stress, I throw in another one. Because you give the body a chance to stop, recalibrate, do what it knows how to do. Your body is designed to do it. You cut your finger and heal, your body is designed to do it. We just rarely get a chance to. And if you've been diagnosed with a major challenge, from what I've seen in my years and experience of working with people and working with Dr. Anne Wiedemann, who started the whole problem, I've seen people turn things around and they call it a miracle. It's just a God-given right. I've had people turn around and ask osteoporosis. I've had people turn around stage 4 colon cancer. And I haven't done it. I've seen it, and I've helped people take themselves to the place where their bodies can do it. There's nothing special about me. I'm just a good coach, guide, and help you find what you already know. I'm not telling anything that you don't already know. It's making you find the time and place within yourself and importance to do it. And stop with the excuses. Everybody's got an excuse. Which is why I came up with the classes, because it's just a little contained arena and area that you do it, and then you're done. You know, so you can say, okay, I did it for 9 days, but in the meantime, you created some new habits. You committed to something consistent. So you can't help but feel a change. Cause and effect is what rules the universe. And I know, like, the 28-day, we go from the 9-day, plant-based, and then we start doing a little raw the second week before we actually do it fast. And I'm telling you, there's miracles that I've seen. I'll show you some of the pictures from some of the people that have taken that class. This is Joette Waters. She was vegetarian for 25 years. We're going to get a camera up here soon, as long as you guys can see on there too. I wish I could show them. There's no way you can put it on your phone and show them Nicole is there.
No.
Anyway, I'm sorry, people. We're going to get this worked out. If any of you are tech savvy, please let me know and whatever you can do to help us out with this. But this is Joette, and she was vegetarian for 25 years. And then she did our detox. I'm going to use that word. And this is how she looked after it.
Oh, wow.
She literally came alive. And that's the kind of thing that you will see in the 9 day. Maybe not that. You literally come alive. Because we start doing more living foods with them. You know, it's the first you're plant-based, and then you cross the bridge, and then you go raw. Okay, let me show you another one. Who else do we have from here? Who's this? Oh, she was losing her hair, and her hair grew back then. You know, just about every symptom that you can. Yep, you did that one. Okay, this is Memory. She's one of my favorites. Memory was a large girl her entire life. She was never small. And she chose to do my detox every other month for 8 months. So she just kept coming on board, because I don't teach them every month. I do different things.
Is that the 28th day? Or?
Yes, this is the 28th day. And after 28 days, doing it for 8 months every other month, this is how she looked.
Oh, my word.
There is a process, and it's amazing. You will see from that. I mean, we've had people lose 6 to 30 pounds within the 28 days, depending on what other things you may be dealing with. I'm so sorry, but if you go to the YouTube, I don't even see if you go to the YouTube. Now I can't even find a little arrow to show more of these. The arrow ran away. Anyway, we've got lots more. But it's amazing what you can expect just by what you're choosing to do here. Cause and effect. Every single thing you put in your mouth creates a reaction that there's no way to get. So when you do the classes, it's kind of like you're contained, you can make a commitment, and you see a rotation. Because what happens otherwise, if I say no meat, fish, chicken, or dairy, she, boy, does she make sense. I'm never going to have dairy again as long as I live. But as long as I'm giving up forever, I'm going to have this little piece today. Long time, never going to have it again, you know. And so you kind of just, your body never really gets a chance to see how it can feel without any of it. So we have my 28 day, and with that we add a few other things. We're still doing yields, native magnesium. We're still doing the enzymes. We're still doing, this is most of the stuff we do in that. It gets a little more involved, actually a lot more involved. But you see tremendous results. And I say, if you haven't done it before, you do the 9 day and you take your way into this one. And then my very last class, I'm going to talk about products and your questions, is my sugar detox. Why do I keep using that word detox and I don't even like it? It's don't say the
sugar break.
The sugar break. You are taking a break from sugar is what I'm recommending that you do. Right? And here's the reason why. Sugar, it is in everything. Your soup, your ketchup, everything, your salad dressing, they put sweetener in everything. And part of the reason they do that is because the human condition, we want salt, fat, and sugar. We're supposed to have salt, fat, and sugar. And I know people on these salt-restricted diets, we're supposed to have salt, but the right salt. is the right minerals for our body. In the olden days, they used to put salt in the farms for the animals. So we're supposed to have salt, we're just not supposed to have table salt. The Morton salt, the whatever salt that salts up. But the Himalayan salt, it's from God, it's pink, it's different colors, and it literally gives minerals to your system. And the beauty of it is you don't need to use as much as when you're using other salts. You don't need to use as much. It's just enough to get the mineral content in there. So we're supposed to have salt, fat, and sugar. So they put the sugar and the fat in there, and they know you're going to eat it, you're going to keep coming back forever. So giving up the sugar is one of the most difficult tasks that we have. And when I put you on my sugar break, I even recommend that you drink fruit. Now, I know people rely on eat white sugar, but I'm talking about honey, I'm talking about maple syrup, I'm talking about all the natural sugars that they got. And by the way, believe me, honey is a beautiful, and I know that people don't eat it, but it's one of the most perfect foods on the planet in the last 2,000 years. It's got the molecular structure of your blood. But it's the sugar. And I know people don't believe, you know, but for me, I do honey from time to time, and I consider myself vegan, plant-based, and I do some honey, because without the bees, we wouldn't exist. Everything would be able to exist with each other. Anyway, I'm going to get away from my excuses, but I even take you away from them. The only thing that's allowed on the sugar break is monk fruit and stevia, because those actually balance your blood sugar levels. So we do recommend that you use those two.
Monk fruit.
Or stevia.
Say that again.
M-O-N-K, monk fruit.
Or what?
Stevia. S-T-E-V-I-A. Yeah. I personally don't care for the taste of stevia, so I don't use it in my restaurant, but it's very good for you. And it actually helps balance your blood sugar, and a lot of people don't mind that. But anyway, I take you off all of it for, what is it, 10 days. It's a short period of time. But it is the most amazing thing that you will start to feel when you do that, when you do the sugar break. And I'm giving you things to balance your blood sugar levels and getting big seed. I'm giving you the algae again. I'm giving you systemic enzymes because they have MSM in them also, and they help balance your blood sugar levels. So and it will be good for that too, where you're keeping score and keeping track. But it is amazing. I like to tell the story. I was a carnivore and I became a vegetarian. And I thought, oh my God, this is how I can heal. And then I went from being a vegetarian to vegan or plant-based. And I thought, oh my God, this is how people heal. And then I went from being vegan, plant-based to raw. And it's like, Jesus, this is how you feel. This is the way you, this is how I'm meant to feel. And then I went from that to giving up sugar for 6 months. I lost another 15 years on how I look. Because the glycosins age you. There's so much. It crystallizes your brain. I truly believe that's the reason for so much dementia and Alzheimer's disease. It's a big part of it. It's the sugar on the brain. Sugar, sugar, sugar. So I take you off for 10 short days. You get to see what it feels like. And then the sugars don't feel quite as good, so much of them really notice it. How addicted you are to the sugars. So I do a sugar break. So a lot of people like to do the 9-day and then they roll into the 28-day and then they roll into the sugar break. It's something they want to just jump in on the sugar break right away. People do that also. It's exceptionally beneficial. And it isn't as difficult as you think it might be to do. Okay. So you have the sugar break first. So do I have any questions about anything I've got so far?
I'd like to say I put my daughter's name under my name. And she is very tech savvy. She was going to come with me this evening, but we were actually at a birthday party. I broke away and left her there, so I gotta go get her. But I hope that if you're not closed, we'll stop back in.
Oh, I would love
that. All right, you can meet her. Well, yeah, she's very. She can do all of this stuff with you. She'll get you ready.
Thank you for breaking away from your birthday party. Skip the birthday cake.
Oh, it's too late for that. But maybe next time.
Nice to meet you.
Right, because when you think about it, you're at work, everybody's got candy on their desk, you walk by, and you're just constantly taking it in when you turn. So I had someone say to me on the internet, because I was talking about my sugar break, and I had someone say to me, well, man was supposed to be fruitarians, and yes, we're supposed to be, but when we were created to be fruitarians, the sugars, they didn't have the sugars in them today. I just talked to my grandmother, who was born today, and she said, we did back in her day. You know, they've added everything as hybrids and sugar. But we were only compliant. You needed that kind of sugar. You weren't sitting at your desk behind a computer. You know, one woman said, well, you know, I know this 90-year-old guy that's in the jungle, and he's still really good. Well, he's not finally free to do it. He's not sitting behind his desk waiting for it to be delivered by the park. So I'm just strongly recommending if you'd like to see a huge change in yourself. I'm competing with you guys over there. Excuse me. Restroom is still open. What was I saying? And you also
sugar.
Oh, sugar, yes. The sugar break. It's a wonderful addition to your whole process of making a change for yourself. Your thinking, your everything starts to change. We don't have to suffer and die. Yes, we are all going to transition at some point. We know we're all going to die. The house we have, and I think my daughter called me all sad the other day. She said, oh my, I have this very dear lady friend of mine. She was 83 years old, and she was a great help, and she was kind, and she was laughing and talking. And the next day, she was dead. Here, that's the way I want to go.
Okay.
I want to be laughing and talking, and the next day, I'm gone. I don't want to linger and suffer and die and be hooked up to a bunch of things. You know? So we all can make a difference. Do you all of a sudden become perfect because you make these changes? Absolutely not. The body has to work with process. We kind of born here, we kind of eat our way down here, and we get back up in the other direction, and we eat our way back up in the other direction. And it doesn't put the joy that you feel, the mastery that you feel, taking charge of you, your life, and realizing that, nobody, I don't even have your answers. I can point you in the right direction to find your answers, because everybody's not supposed to be in the same place at the same time. We're called the journey of life. And I don't know where your journey's going to take you. I don't know where your DNA came from. You know, if I were to my DNA, I shouldn't be around anymore. So I'm here to say, take charge where you can. Put your time and money and energy into you. And I promise you, I make a guarantee. Not too many places you can go and get a guarantee. You can't get a guarantee from my doctor. You can't get it from your candidate. But you can get it from me. You know why? Because I'm just helping you step back into, I got the best business partner on the planet. I'm just helping you step back into what you intended to do. How can it not work? There's no way. So no matter how little or how much you do, there's no way for it not to work. There is a guarantee. You will make those changes. You will feel those changes. You will win those changes. But it's up to you to decide where you want to take this. How far you may not succeed as much as you think you should. It's not about what you should be doing. It's comparing yourself to where you were, how you think you should be going, instead of where you think you should be. But you will see results beyond your wildest dreams. So I invite you all to try any of my classes. I do one-on-one, but I don't enjoy them because I don't get results that I do in the classroom. It's like on Marco Polo, it's so great. Someone said, you know, I'm having such a hard time doing this. And then everybody chimed in because you're all in the same place at some point in time. You're not that unique and different that you're having a difficult time with. So when we share with the community and do it, it kind of helps too, my friends. I'll work with you on a little bit about these things too, and I don't think I get the same results. So the classes I strongly recommend, but if you wanted to walk out of here today with just to do something different, while you mull and percolate over what you might want to do, I think my green meal smoothie is a fabulous way to start your day and an introduction to a meal. You know, we don't necessarily have to have breakfast, lunch, and dinner. That's a man-made thing. But when you feel hungry, you have that green meal smoothie. A lot of my clients who are in the class, they'll start the day with baking soda and water, and then when they feel hungry, they'll do the green meal smoothie. But they may not feel hungry until about 1 or 2 o'clock, or they may not feel hungry again. Stop your snacking throughout the day when your body is being fed real nutrients. So we have a green meal smoothie. That's a wonderful thing to take away today. You mix it with flax oil, left with some granules, wait for you to do some follow up with some granules, and you make a fabulous meal for yourself. Green meal and fiber. I give these to my 8-year-old husband every single day. And they're in all the programs that she says, algae is the first food on the planet. So we have other ways to do it. We can do it with spirulina, we can do it with chlorella, but this is capsules. So if you're starting out, it's a great way to get some vibrant and dense ecology. And you'd be surprised the energy that goes in the ocean. So green living fiber is a wonderful way to go. Enzymes, of course, we already talked about enzymes. I have two types of enzymes. I have probiotic enzymes, and I have my plant digestive enzymes, and then I have systemic enzymes. And the systemic enzymes have to be done in the stomach for their pain and inflammation. But anyway, I have all these wonderful products. I won't go into a long sales story about them. You can go to my website, shopcarolines.com, and read about them. You can DM me. You can email me. You can find ways to reach out to me. You can give me your questions for the next time I do this so I can answer your specific questions. How would we come on again? But right now I'm going to turn the floor over to you. Can I bring some samples out too? Sorry for the people that aren't here. I wanted you to try some of my vegan plant-based food. Can I get the food ready, folks? Susan, I'm going to give you a little food to try for the day, just so people will have vegan food so we can see. It isn't foreign. I'm kind of known for making everything taste the way it used to taste. No, I'm waiting for the food. I was just checking to see my channel. So, do I have any questions while we're waiting?
For the sugar break, is it that whole kit? Or
is yes, the sugar break is the kit.
And that's the
book? Yeah, we
just
have
the book. Get just the book.
Well, you know what we'll do? We'll finish up and we'll have some ready for you to taste at the end to make sure they're ready.
Okay.
And we're going to give you a little showing and a little vegan pizza so that you can see and you won't feel like you're missing anything. By the way, when I teach the 9-day revival, I will give you, I have a whole box of food that you can buy at Target and Walmart and Jewel here in the Chicago area, where you can get plant-based food anywhere. That's the beauty of it. You don't just have to come to my restaurant. You don't have to just be in Chicago. When I started 50 years ago, there were only two restaurants in Chicago. That was it. And now they're everywhere. That's my dream. Okay, my dream has come true. So you got lots of places to go. If you're other parts of the country, you can get plant-based food anywhere. So that's the beauty of it. So do I have any other questions? Magnesium, and calcium, it helps bring the balance to your system, and you will have some beautiful poops the next morning. You'll poop like a baby and you'll sleep like a baby throughout the night.
And this is
this is one of the supplements included in the 9-day and in the sugar break and in the 28-day. I'm very big on pooping. What goes in must come out. If it didn't, there you go. What's it doing? It's building. It's going on you. So the alternating magnesium, you take this a half an hour before bed. It's recommended. So
how many?
You could do 1 to 4. I wouldn't do that consistently, but you could do 1 or 2. Start off with that. I'm just making a recommendation. Everybody's listening. And if you're very runny in the morning, you might do that for 2 or 3 days until you rest, until you can rest up. You'll get into it with yourself and figure it out. But you'll be pooping.
No, but I also feel like I sleep better.
Well, that's what it's for. Yeah, magnesium makes you sleep. If you take it a half hour before you sleep, you'll sleep through the night. You'll sleep like a baby and poop like 1 in the morning. Any other questions? I guess I made myself clear.
The soy lecithin.
Yeah, a lot of people are concerned about soy. I don't have a lot of concern about soy. I don't eat it in the raw form, you know, but I think it's a wonderful bridge. But if people want to do the class and not do the soy lecithin, you can buy sunflower lecithin. So the soy makes it like creamy and emulsified and just really tastes delicious. So I've taken all the other things away from you. I want you to have something delicious. So you're missing. So it's all included in the 28-day kit. But you can buy the things singularly inside if you want to try this or if you want to try that. But the main thing that I'm trying to get across is you want to try. You want to do, not try. You want to do something different. Because what you're doing and what you're comfortable with now is what's got you where you are right now.
Yes, we have not all the milk.
I think it's a wonderful alternative to cow's milk. Oat milk, almond milk, all of the milk.
I put almond milk in my oat milk.
Beautiful. And then you can take it one more step and just soak it in overnight.
Yes.
You have raw oat milk.
Overnight oats, yes.
Then you can have raw oat milk.
Say that again. If I do soak it overnight, do it.
With the almond milk, and it'll be really creamy and delicious the next day.
In the refrigerator.
By the way, I have food prep classes too. I forgot to mention that. We have them going on here regularly. We got one coming up next Wednesday. So you might want to join them. We did some fabulous food the last time. We had cabbage steaks. Yes, we do. We did a very parfait. What else do we
have?
I did a lot of food. And I'll do a lot this week too. I love feeding people and making them food. So join us for the food prep classes coming up. What's the day of it? June 7th?
June 7th.
June 7th is the next cooking and uncooking class. Will be June 7th. Actually, you can go to my YouTube channel and see the last class. It's up for free just this time if you want to entice people to want to sign up for the classes. So if you go to the YouTube channel, you can see the last cooking class. We have a lot of fun.
Nice.
A lot of good food and a lot of fun. So we've got that coming. So just check out the website and join me wherever it feels right. And please remember that if you don't take care of your body, the most nutritious machine you'll ever be given. Great young live. Thank you so much.
What's the difference in your class that you're doing, and holistic? Now, I have the experience of holistic. I've been in holistic.
Yeah, well, under the body of holistic, there's so many areas that you can take that. You know, you can do quantum healing, you can do detoxing, you can do cleansing, you can do raw foods, you can do so many things. So I think what I'm teaching is what I've lived for 50 years, and I think it encompasses everything. So when you say holistic, it's kind of, I do a little bit of everything.
The person that I went through the holistic class with, he was vegan for 18 years. You might know me, but he's very popular.
Who is it?
Dr. Williams.
Oh, sure.
I went.
Dr. Kim Williams?
Huh?
Kim Williams? Or the one in Indiana?
Derek?
The one in Harvey.
Derek. Dr. Derek
Williams.
Oh, yeah.
I did a year with him. I was with him for a year.
Beautiful. So you got a beautiful start. Your life.
I mean, it was 2015.
That's
so
nice.
From September to February, I lost 46 pounds.
Wow. Absolutely. Wow. You do something different, you get different results. Congratulations.
Yeah, for people didn't know me. But then I left. I don't know what happened. It found me back.
And that's why I think it's important to create a community.
Yes.
And that's why I believe it's important to have a community of people that you can rely on that are feeling and doing the same thing. Absolutely. And I believe the only reason I'm so successful is because I live in the middle of it day in and day out. And to be honest with you, I created that for me because I wouldn't be alive if I hadn't lived. So it's putting yourself in the middle of it consistently, which is what keeps me there. And now I'm here, so you can come here consistently. You're making friends here tonight. I know my Gina and Susan will love to invite you in as a sister of theirs.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. So you can and go Nia. By the way, my Nia is back here. She is our colon therapist.
Yes. We know her.
Yeah, come on.
No.
So, what I have to say about my Nia is
she's the best.
People know I have been in. People know that I have been in this business for 4 years, and I've had some of the most incredible colon therapists on the planet.
Yes.
Right? Some of you may remember Star, the nurse. She was incredible. I mean, I had some wonderful. But I have to say, this lady here takes it to new levels. She loves what she's doing. She's gifted, and she won't let you get off that table for.
I got witnesses.
So she is incredible. No, I have to say, you know what? Because she loves what she's doing.
Yeah.
This isn't just a job for her or whatever. She loves cleaning the bowels of the earth, and that's a very special human being to sit in that room day in and day out and make sure she gets you cleaned out. So she's a very special human being, and if you happen to be in this area, you need to come and experience those hands.
I need to
make your colon.
She runs around telling everybody, but she's good, I promise.
She is.
I let everybody know. And I'm a trained colon therapist. Anyway, any other questions? Any questions? And if you have questions out there, guys, please send them over, and then I'll make sure that I answer them. I'm not real good with DM, with answering people. I don't like being humble, but I will try. But send me your questions, your complaints, and anything that you may need that this community can help you from. And if you want to join our Marco Polo, I think, come on and join our Marco Polo, even if you're enjoying our classes, and listen to what we're doing. You can go talk to it. Just download Marco Polo and...
Yeah, they have to DM you, but they also have to do the 28-day or the 9-day.
Well, she's saying you got to be in it. I was going to give it to you for free today. Okay, it's not me. But anyway, you'll join Marco Polo with us and join the community. I will be doing these every month, sometimes twice a month, just because I feel people need to hear it. And I need to say it to remind us all. The food prep will be at 6 o'clock this time, right?
Yes, 6 o'clock.
It'll be 6 o'clock.
Oh,
yeah, we made it earlier. We didn't get out of here 6 o'clock. So stay for your pizza. My baby may have some chili for you. Sorry I can't offer you any, but when you come to Calgary, say, hey, Karen, I saw you on the whatever. And I have some chili pizza and chili. I'll do my best to do what I can to give you some. And once again, everybody's talking now. They're enjoying me. So remember, if you don't take care of your body, the most magnificent machine you'll ever feel. Thank you.
Bravo.
Okay.
Good.
We'll see.
I'm not sure how to turn this off. Yes.
I think I'll
have to tell you everything I need to do.
And then you can't go.
I think this is the
veggie lovers.
Oh,
so I have to
go
give it to
the
people who haven't tried it
yet.
I'm
supposed to have enough
for everybody. We
got some for everybody. Yay! I got
some more. I'm good for you all.
Y'all want to try pizza?
I did JJ's. She's on. I did her.
Very good, Karen. So nice. You do need to hear it again.
$154
each.
You will not be disappointed, I promise you.
But it's actually my person, right?
Right. Going to dance and they do some,
Dr. Willie?
What's that? And they do the panoramic, and they bring them in. Michael Jackson did a show. Have you ever been to a Cirque du Soleil show before? So you know how it is. Okay, there's so much stuff going on, so.
Is that what the
Michael Jackson? Yes, it's a Cirque du Soleil. But they have the Broadway show. My daughter said, because she didn't particularly like it, but they got Broadway. They got the MJ Broadway coming out here. MJ on the Broadway. Michael Jackson out there. But they said they selected.
It was really good.
Oh my gosh, that pizza is so good.
I know.
She tastes so.
This is my favorite one.
eye, that's what you're going to be. No, the evil eye is, it's a, correct, it's a, it's, except for this one, so, this is Tiffany. I got three more. And then my grandmother, lady, 11 years old, and I got her. My other granddaughter, her mom already did one. And these are the doors, they don't anticipate what I should have done. I told them, you know, to put them on at random, but all of these were, because I got to match this. But because I got it. So I got one bracelet that has, I got to get a safety latch on it. It has all the little places I've traveled. So when I went, even if I didn't go to that country, if they had other countries, I bought it. Because I went to the North Sea Jazz Festival in Rotterdam, Amsterdam. And my friend and I, and my husband, we did what we call European, hop-on, hop-off. So we stayed after the jazz festival, 3 days, we stayed there an extra day, and then we flew to Italy. And then we stayed there. While we were there, we went to New Rome, so we did go to Naples and Pompeii. Yeah. Oh, Naples. It could be downright depressing, especially if you go where they sit. But anyway, we did that and then we left there and flew into Spain, or Lord of Living in Spain. So while we were there, we went across the water to anyway, we went there. We went yesterday in the bullet tent. So we got to see
Oh, this one?